We begin with the return of the birthers.
Grown up, are you kidding me?
I heard he's a bad student.
Birth certificate.
One of the great cons in the history of politics.
With me now are two MSNBC political analysts, Salon Editor-at-Large Joan Walsh and Mother Jones Magazine's David Korn, the author of Showdown. David, is there a constituency for Donald Trump? Are there a group of Americans out there who are waiting for a Trump endorsement so that they know what to do, or Trump involvement so that they know to whom to write checks?
Gosh, I really hope that's not the case, Michael, because then we're in deep doo-doo. But I do think he's playing to part of the Republican base, which just won't give up the ghost on making, on portraying Barack Obama as some foreign, otherish entity. I mean, it just won't go away. And whether it's that he doesn't get America, doesn't understand America, as Mitt Romney always says, or whether it's that he's not really born here, or that he doesn't understand the economy, or that he's a secret socialist Muslim. All these things, you know, it's so ingrained in their view of the president, even after 3 years plus of his presidency, that,
but anybody,
you know,
but David, anybody who'd be motivated on that issue is already in the Romney camp. That's the part I don't understand. Let me show you so that everybody at home knows what we're talking about. In an interview with the Daily Beast's Lloyd Grove, Donald Trump would not back down from his questions about the president, pointing now to a photo and biography written by a literary agency in 1991, recently uncovered by Andrew Breitbart's website. Trump said to Grove, "Look, it's very simple. A book publisher came out 3 days ago and said that in his written synopsis of his book. He said that he was born in Kenya, raised in Indonesia. His mother never spent a day in the hospital. Actually, the literary agency assistant who wrote the description calls it a mistake, a fact-checking error on her part. But Trump doesn't believe it. And he told Grove, quote, that's what he told the literary agent. That's the way life works. He didn't know he was running for president, so he told the truth. The literary agent wrote down what he said. He said he was born in Kenya and raised in Indonesia, and now they're saying it was just a mistake, just like his Kenyan grandmother said he was born in Kenya, and she pointed down the road to the hospital, and after people started screaming at her, he said, oh, I mean Hawaii. Give me a break, said the Trumpster. And here, by the way, you can see that the 1991 literary agency photo and description of President Obama unearthed by the folks, as I say, at Breitbart. You know, Joan Walsh, I have to make this observation. The folks at Breitbart say, we don't buy the birther argument. We're putting this forward because we think it's evidence of the shoddy job done by the media 4 years ago to vet the now president. What do you make of that?
They're bottom feeders. I mean, my God, I didn't think it was possible to get lower than Andrew Breitbart, but his spawn have gotten lower than Andrew Breitbart. You put that out there, you know that you're aiding and abetting birtherism. And Michael, you know, the three of us have better things to do on a holiday weekend than talk about the farce that is Donald Trump. But we're here doing it because Mitt Romney lacks the spine to stand up and say, I'm sorry, I'm not going to have a fundraiser with you. And it's really an important moment. I mean, I think that the Romney campaign slogan is leave no Obama hater behind. He uses surrogates like Trump to feed the base. They don't, you know, we've got to also say, David's probably right. People who love Trump will vote for Romney, or maybe they'll stay home. There's no great love for Mitt Romney in the crazy crackpot Republican base, that part of the base. They're not all crazy crackpots. So, you know, maybe his campaign thinks that there's some percentage in him standing by the orange-haired bully and talking to him and having his hug and having his endorsement. But it's
and
a sad
forget,
day.
What's the proper response?
Joan, what's the proper response? I know we're probably thinking of recent incidents on the campaign trail, the Hillary Rosen incident, where there was repudiation of what she said, as I recall, from both sides of the aisle. If it's taken place in the birther business, I'm unaware of it, and I'd love to be corrected. I don't think that anybody came out and condemned Trump within the GOP and said, like, what the hell's he talking about?
No, the campaign jumped out. I mean, I like Kevin Madden, but there he was. You know, it doesn't mean that we endorse his views. He endorses ours. No, there is not. And, you know, we've seen this from the beginning where John Boehner says, it's really not my job to tell people what to think. They aid and abet the birthers because they're afraid of them. They're afraid of that energy within their own party. This is a moment where someone, Mitt Romney preferably, could say, you know, I like Donald Trump, but this is a kind of politics that I don't want to truck in. You know,
Michael.
honestly, one of the saddest days, one of the saddest days in the last 4 years was when Barack Obama, our first black president, had to stand up and show his papers to that wealthy white bully. That was a low moment, and Mitt Romney should want to distance himself from that humiliation. It's time for him to do
David, I'm going to let you jump into this for sure, but the one observation I would put forth is that this election is all about those very few who are legitimately undecided. And I just cannot believe as a political proposition that it benefits the Romney campaign to have this issue relitigated. David, your thought?
Well, I think you're right. I don't think this plays to the suburbanite independent voters. And I don't think Donald Trump is doing this with any strategy in mind, certainly not one that comes from the Boston campaign headquarters of Mitt Romney. But the question is, once this does happen, what does Mitt Romney do about it? It reminds me of what happened a couple of weeks ago when he was confronted by a supporter who said that the president should be tried for treason. Right. Unlike what John McCain did last time around when he said to a woman who called Barack Obama an Arab, he said, he didn't do anything. He just kind of laughs it off. And remember,
allow me to show you both. But remember, in advance of next Tuesday's fundraiser with Mitt Romney and Donald Trump in Vegas, of course, Romney campaign advisor Kevin Madden told Andrea Mitchell that Trump's support of the campaign doesn't mean that Mitt Romney subscribes to what Trump believes.
I think what's most important to remember is when you support somebody for running for office, that you are essentially signing on to their views. And Governor Romney has made very clear that he disagrees with comments like that. He's made it clear every single time it's become a topic of conversation, whether it's in the media or whether it's in the blogosphere. He's made it very clear that he disagrees with that.
And that's so he'll stand up next to Donald Trump. And
he'll talk about he'll stand up next to Donald Trump. He'll talk about why he wants to be president, why he believes that the economy needs to be turned around.
See, I think that argument would hold more water if Trump weren't still out there as recently as today on The View, joking about this subject. If he didn't continue to drive it home, then I'd be more inclined to say you can't hold a presidential candidate responsible for his supporters,
but he's
even
using,
those who are the biggest benefactors.
Yes,
Joan, go ahead.
Go, David.
Okay, thanks, Joan. But the point here is that he's using Trump to raise money for his own campaign.
Right.
You don't have to get out there and renounce everybody who says, I support you, and I also believe this crazy thing. That's not a game. I don't expect candidates to do that. But when you're using that person, and he's making a prominent argument against the president, your opponent, that's crackpot, and then you stand next to him, and you are legitimizing him. And don't forget, it was only a couple of weeks ago that Donald Trump was feting Ann Romney at her birthday, and helping the campaign that way, too. So this is not just, we don't have to talk about crazy supporters. This is someone who they are using to raise money for Mitt Romney when they don't have to. It's their decision. It's their choice. And they're making the wrong one.
Joan, I referenced The View. Allow me to show you what took place this morning when Joy Behar tried to have a little fun with Trump, and he continued his calls for the president's birth certificate.
I have something for you. My birth certificate. Don't believe it!
I'd like to see Obama's.
Joan, it's an issue that's just not going to go away so long as Trump is still on the stage in a presidential context.
Obviously. And what I was going to say, Michael, is that, Trump is using Romney, too. If Trump wanted to be, somehow morph into an elder statesman of the party, he would shut his trap about this and he would enjoy the limelight and enjoy the fact that they're raffling off a dinner with him and he's a big celebrity like George Clooney or President Clinton. I mean, talk about a stature gap between the two parties. That's what Obama raffled off to his supporters. But anyway, if he were trying to rehabilitate himself and play a positive role, he would shut up about this. But he's actually humiliating Mitt Romney. In my opinion, he's really asking for Mitt Romney. He knows that he's making trouble, and he doesn't care. He wants to float this issue, and he's going to use a presidential campaign to do it, and he's going to humiliate Romney because he knows he doesn't have the backbone to stand up to him.
Last night was a pretty extraordinary night here on Hardball. Chris asked Newt Gingrich in the midst of that great interview why some Republicans can't let go of the birther talk.
I don't think you believe a word of this, but why do some people in your party, including the very wealthy Donald Trump, who I have mixed feelings about, of course, like everybody does, perhaps not you, and I like him in some ways, but he's not stupid enough to believe this birther stuff, and yet he keeps playing it. Barack Obama has a birth certificate, the same as ours. Right?
Yeah.
He comes from a father who's from another country, but he's clearly locally born in Hawaii. Why do some people in your party keep pushing he's not an American? Beats me. Thank you.
Michael.
David Corn, it beats the speaker, the former speaker.
But wait a second. Let's not let the speaker off easy here. Because what did he say last year? He said that Barack Obama, the only way to understand this guy is if you realize he has an anti-colonialist Kenyan perspective. The guy who took out Osama bin Laden. I mean, this is, you know, he's had his own crackpot way of dealing with this overarching issue that the president is different, that he's a foreigner, that he doesn't have an American mentality, that he doesn't understand America. He did it in maybe a more sophisticated, esoteric way, but it's the same type of baloney that the birthers are passing, and you know, and that's just how Newt did it. So when he says, "Oh, distances himself from birtherism," it's really a disingenuous activity.
David Corn, thank you for being here. Joan Walsh, have a great Memorial Day weekend. We appreciate you both as always.
Thanks.